Jesus Christ Superstar is the name of the show, coming to Southern California for two nights in July. July 20th at the Honda Center and the 26th at Staples Center. Our friend Brandon Boyd is in studio with us right now. He plays Judas Iscariot in the show. Was it a tough decision, a tough question for you to say yes to, Brandon? Did you have reservations about taking on a show like this, or is it something you just were super psyched to hear?
I was over the moon about the offer. I wanted to make sure that I was making the right decision before I said yes. So I asked them for, I think, about a week or 10 days. And I was in South America with Incubus when the call came. So I was wooed by the South Americans and the atmosphere. So it would have been really easy to be like, yes, yes, yes. So, you know, see. So I asked for a little bit of time, which they happily granted. And then the first thing I did was I asked the guys in Incubus. I was like, you guys, I got this really weird phone call. And I told them what it was. And they all were like, see, do it. Yes.
But I would think a guy like you with your various bands and your books and your art and all the other stuff and just living life, having time to serve and stuff, I would think when you make a commitment like this, you know that you're giving up time that you could be using to do other things. So you have to choose wisely.
Yeah, that was the whole reason behind taking a moment. And I also wanted to make sure that it was that I'd be able to do it justice, you know, because I love the show. And I, like I said, I grew up on it. So
how do you answer that question if for yourself? Can I do it justice?
Lock myself in a echoey bathroom and
just try it out.
Sing the songs.
Start singing Heaven on Their Minds and see if I got it. And I'm actually serious. Like I went and I threw a couple of like the bigger notes and I was like, maybe I can do this. Yes.
CC.
Yes.
So Jesus Christ Superstar started in 1970 on stage, ran on Broadway for years and years and years. It was a big movie in 1973. Mm-hmm. The songs don't sound dated, though. That's what's interesting. I mean, that's what's beautiful about Andrew Lloyd Webber is you can't tell what decade his songs were written because they all seem so timeless.
Yeah, he's a unique cat. I think that there's a level of genius to what he does, actually. And part of it is that timelessness, but part of it, too, is like, if you listen to Jesus Christ Superstar as a record, it is so weird, like wonderfully weird. It's really, really, like, it's almost psychedelic in a way. And obviously it came from an era of psychedelia.
Sure.
Yeah, it's wonderful. I'm a proper fan of his work.
Do you know anything about what the staging is going to be like that they're going to do? I mean, since you're playing such large places, and are you going to be in the round?
I don't know if it's in the round. In fact, it probably is not, because a lot of it is it's a beautiful set, but most of it is on these giant screens too. So it's you're watching a live performance, but then there's cameras sort of hidden around the stage and you see the performance projected on the giant screen. So it's like you're watching a live performance and a movie.
Oh, that's
at
cool.
The same
you were
time.
Saying during the song that you haven't rehearsed with the cast yet.
Right.
Is that a little scary?
No, not really.
I'm
getting to the point now where I'm tired of doing it alone.
In the bathroom.
Right. Raised eyebrows, as you can't see. And I can't wait to just jump in bed with everybody. It's going to be so much more fun when you have company.
Well, you're going to be on stage with the show in New Orleans in less than a month. You open on June 9th.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we're allowing for all of about 10 days of rehearsal with everybody. But everyone's coming in. These are like crazy professionals. Like everybody really knows what they're doing. And
that's your job is to know 100% what you're doing before you even start rehearsing.
I guarantee by the time we get on stage in New Orleans, we're going to be like sick of practicing.
Are you scared?
No, at the moment, no.
Should you be?
Are you ever
probably
scared,
Brandon? I do get scared. I do get nervous, actually. I've learned how to sort of filter those nerves into a sort of a joyful energy, though. I actually love to pursue things that give me that nervous energy because I feel like that is me walking in the right direction.
But you being challenged.
Yeah, if you go, you're like, oh, I can do that, cool. That's sort of like you can become very easily complacent that way. And so I love to sort of pursue things where I'm like, ooh, can I do that? I don't know. Let's try. And I think that makes us sort of, you know, better
artists. Now, you probably don't know the answer to this yet because you haven't gotten to work with the props, but do you think there'll be real food for you to eat at the Last Supper?
It's a good
question.
I mean,
they got to put something up on stage, right?
Right, they do. I'm feeling it's probably going to be Kool-Aid and gluten-free.
I mean,
toast.
I assume that's dinner, right? Every night on stage is the Last Supper, I would think.
Right.
And it better be good.
It better be.
I'm not sure he's done any research into that.
Too early. Like I said, I thought it might be too early to ask. So let me give you the ticket information again for people who want to see this. Honda Center on July 20th. Tickets going on sale for that show through Ticketmaster.com this Friday at 10 a.m. And then the following weekend, Saturday, July 26th, you're going to be at Staples Center. Tickets can be purchased at AXS.com. And the thing is opening up on June 9th and is scheduled right now to run through the end, the middle of August, right? So a couple of months you're going to be out on the road.
That's right, yeah.
This is more interesting to you to do it this way than to just be another production and open on Broadway and stay in the same spot in New York?
This is actually a little bit more what I know. I know.
Yeah, I guess.
I know stadiums. Tour buses, yeah. And arenas and stadiums and stuff. And I think I'd be way more nervous if it was sitting in one place because then people could like come back multiple times and see me not do well. I don't know.
It's just so weird for you as a music fan that you have a job where you're traveling the country with Johnny Rotten. I mean, that he's going to see you coming and hide. You're going to want to talk to him all the time, right?
Or vice versa. I don't know.
I know I would. I know I would never run out of questions for him with the life that he's led.
Yeah, he's a cool dude, man. He dresses real sharp, too. He's got some cool style. Got the same eyes as the stuff that we got to know from back in the day too. Like it's that same
a little crazy
look in his eye. Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
Definitely. Yeah. Well, this show sounds awesome, Brandon. Lisa, you're gonna go see this, right?
Absolutely. Are you kidding me?
No, it really
all
does.
Over the country.
It really does. We're very excited for you, Brandon. Congratulations. You. We can't wait to see it when it comes to town, and we wish you nothing but success with it, my friend.
Thank you, guys.